أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين I hope and pray everyone is having a great and productive Ramadan this year. May Allah accept all of our efforts and our prayers and our fasting and all our good deeds. Today I wanted to reflect over an important Quranic idea. This idea of the signs of God, Ayatullah. And this is something that populates the entire Quran, nearly every single page. Allah Azza wa Jal references His signs. And this is a topic that should be of interest and should be very relevant to our time. We are seeing in our lifetime unprecedented changes in so many areas and situations of life. We're witnessing the power of a pandemic. We're witnessing things that we never have imagined. Signs of Allah are all around us. So one of the great Quranic ideas is that Allah created the world for human beings as a test. And in this world, created signs. And these signs point to Allah Azza wa Jal. There's a great piece of poetry in Arabic that is once repeated so much that it's difficult to say who the author is. It's been attributed to Imam Shafi'i. It's attributed to the pre-Islamic poet Labid ibn Rabi'a, as well as Abu al-Atahiyya. But the verse goes something like this: فَيَا عَجَبًا كَيْفَ يُعْصَى الْإِلَهُ أَمْ كَيْفَ يَجْحَدُ الْجَاحِدُ وَلِلَّهِ فِي كُلِّ تَحْرِيكَةٍ وَتَسْكِينَةٍ أَبَدًا شَاهِدُ. And in the final line, and I'll come back to this poem at the end, وَفِي كُلِّ شَيْءٍ لَهُ آيَةٌ تَدُلُّ عَلَىٰ أَنَّهُ وَاحِدُ. In every single thing in the world, there is a sign, an ayah, that points to the fact that He is one, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we are surrounded by Allah's signs. Unfortunately, human beings are, generally speaking, many of us are blind to those signs. We ask the wrong questions. We ask, why is Allah not speaking? We ask, why don't we have any answers? We ask all these questions. All we have to do is open our hearts and our eyes and our ears. No less than 357 verses in the Quran speak about the signs of Allah. So it's interesting analysis, research I've done on this topic. And so I'll share with you some amazing numbers and some amazing statistics and facts about the signs of Allah. So keep this in mind, that we are created in this world. Allah created the human being, and He created this world for us to populate as a test. But He didn't leave us alone. The very first verse that references the signs of Allah is on like the third or fourth page. Now we are in the third, going on the fourth day of Ramadan. Many of us may have come across that in our Taraweeh. I know we're not reciting the entire Quran, but we're reciting the beginning. So there's a verse where Allah speaks about the origin story of humanity, the story of Adam alayhi salam. Allah says in Surah Al-Baqarah, قُلْ نَهْبِطُوا مِنْهَا جَمِيعًا. So Allah, after the whole story of Adam in Jannah, in paradise where he originally lived, Allah then commanded him to leave and come to the earth and live in the earth. But that command came with the following promise. Allah said to Adam, فَإِمَّا يَأْتِيَنَّكُمْ مِنِّي هُدَى فَمَنْ تَبِعَ هُدَايَ فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. This was a traumatic experience for Adam to leave Jannah and to come to the earth. You know, our goal, we live in the earth, we're born in the earth, and our goal is to make it to Jannah. Imagine Adam alayhi salam, he started out in paradise, and then he came back into the earth. Or he was sent then subsequently to the earth. That must have been traumatic. Allah said, don't worry. There will be guidance coming to you from me. And whoever follows that guidance, there is no fear nor sorrow upon them. And then the next verse, he talks about his signs. He says, وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا وَكَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِنَا أُولَٰئِكَ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ. As for those who reject and disbelieve in our signs, they will be the inhabitants of hellfire, living therein forever. So this is a great opening to the signs of Allah. The origin story of humanity tells us that this world we're going to live in, and we are living in now, is a world where Allah placed within it signs. It's the world that He's guiding us periodically and continuously. We're not left alone in this world. All we have to do is open eyes. Those who reject these signs, then they deserve nothing but the hellfire. So if you look at from another perspective, how Allah discusses His signs, so in several verses, Allah says that He revealed these signs. So did Allah create this earth? But He actively revealed certain signs that point to Him into the right way. There are many verses like that, including, for instance, وَلَقَدْ أَنزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ آيَاتٌ بَيِّنَاتٌ. Verily, we have revealed unto you open manifest signs, ayat. So some of these signs are active. Allah sent them down, and there's something that you cannot deny. They're so overwhelming in their character. And then some of those signs are, Allah talks about them in the context of Him showing those signs actively to us. So I want you to think about this idea of the signs of God surrounding all of us, but these signs are not just passive signs that you need a code book to see. These signs are all around us. Allah revealed many of them, and some of them Allah actively showed us. So this idea of yurikum ayatihi, in one verse Allah says, wa yurikum ayatihi la'allakum ta'qilun. We show you, or He shows you His signs so that you may have intellect, or you may reflect over them. Allah says about Fir'aun, He shares some history, certain periods of history, He brought down open signs, like He sent those big, great signs to Fir'aun and his people. وَلَقَدْ أَرَيْنَاهُ آيَاتِنَا كُلَّهَا فَكَذَّبَ وَأَبَى. We sent, or we showed the signs to Fir'aun, and you know, despite that, he rejected. So there's so many verses that speak about Allah showing us His signs. So it's not just that the signs are there, but we have to realize Allah revealed them and He showed them to us. Not only that, and just think about the mercy of Allah. And not only that, Allah makes these signs clear to us. He clarifies them. This is idea of bayan, bayanul ayat. So, for instance, in the verses about fasting, you know, this is the month of Ramadan. All the verses about fasting, what's the last thing Allah says after all the lessons of fasting? He says, كَذَلِكَ يُبَيِّنُ اللَّهُ آيَاتِهِ لِلنَّاسِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَّقُونَ. So we have clarified His signs, or He has clarified, Allah has clarified His signs for human beings so that they may be aware of Allah, they may attain taqwa. So this idea of bayan, وَيُبَيِّنُ اللَّهُ لَكُمُ الْآيَاتِ, again and again in the Quran, in about 14 places, Allah says that He makes the signs clear to us. So these signs are made very clear to us. And then not only that, there are some people, okay, their eyes are closed, they're surrounded by the sign, but it's not enough. So they have to be shown them. But then it's still not enough, they don't understand. So then Allah says that we show the signs in different and diverse ways. There's this idea of tasrif. So this tasrif, sarrafa, in Arabic means to repeat, to show again and again. So Allah is so merciful, He could have left it there. But how many verses He speaks about that? He says, "Unzur kayfa nusarrifu al-ayat thumma hum yaslifun." Look at how we repeat the signs and yet they still reject. So Allah not only repeats the signs the same way, but He repeats them in diverse ways. "Unzur kayfa nusarrifu al-ayati la'allahum yafqahun." Look at how we keep repeating the signs in various ways to wake us up. So you find when you examine these verses in the Quran, but we realize that this is not a passive world where Allah created the world and left us alone. This is a world where Allah is Rabb, He is Mudabbir, He is the controller, He is the one who's actively involved in every affair of the universe. And again, trying to wake us up, trying to show us the signs, trying to have us find the way back, subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is from His mercy. So not only that, so there are so many levels of mercy in how Allah shows us His signs. So among them are tafsilul ayat. In Arabic, fassala means to explain clearly. Sometimes you have children or you have certain individuals. Some of us, we don't understand certain things. So there's all of us have certain topics that we don't really understand. So we need them spelled out plainly. So we need that particular topic. We need someone to say or someone to break it down and speak slowly, step by step, A, B, and C, all those points. This is called tafsil, fassal. And Allah says, وَكَذَلِكَ نُفَصِّلُ الْآيَاتِ وَلِتَسْتَبِينَ سَبِيلُ الْمُجْرِمِينَ. This, and so we spelled out plainly our signs so that the mujrimeen would be their way, their wrong way would be apparent. So again and again, about 14 verses as well, Nufassilu al-ayat, Allah speaks about Nufassilu al-ayat. And finally, another way of a manifestation of Allah's mercy in these signs is that He didn't just put the signs around us, but He also sent human beings to speak to us in our language, to show and point these signs out, and to call us back to His way. So these are the messengers. Or 80 verses in the Quran, Allah speaks about the messengers and the signs. So Allah uses the messengers to bring the guidance to us, either through scripture or revelation, which is ayat, where the messengers, they recite these verses to us. وَالَّذِي بَعَثَ فِي الْأُمِّيِّينَ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ. He is one who sent a messenger among you to recite his verses, his signs to you. So these signs are not only the scripture, the verses, the revelation that Allah sent down, but they're also the natural signs around us. So Allah sent human beings also to speak to us, to show us and point out these signs. So when you think about all of this, my brothers and sisters who are watching, Allah bless you all, you find that Allah created this world and He is definitely, for sure, without a doubt, Arhamur Rahimeen. He is extremely merciful. He wants us to follow His guidance. He wants us to make it to paradise. And because of that, He did not leave us alone. We don't believe in a world where we're left alone. Like Spinoza was a philosopher. So there's an idea of Spinoza's God. And that informs many modern people how they look at the world. So Spinoza said, I believe in a God that's not actively involved in the affairs of the universe, but a God who revealed Himself in the laws of nature and stepped back and let the world run itself. The Quranic view is in stark contrast to that. We believe Allah is Ar-Rabb. He is Al-Muqeem. He is Al-Mudabbir. He is the maintainer, the sustainer, the active manager of the affairs of the universe. Not a leaf falls and any single tree, except that Allah knows it and He manages it and He wills it, and nothing happens other than His will. So this Quranic view is very merciful. We are surrounded by signs. So if after you see all the signs around us, and after you see that Allah actively showed them to us, after you see that Allah made them clear to us, Allah repeated them to us in diverse ways, Allah spelled them out plainly to us, Allah sent us messengers, Allah revealed signs in periods of our history. After that, if anyone rejects these signs and he has these doubts, well, how do we know Allah exists? How do we know anything is real? And so on and so forth. Then they're really deaf, dumb, and blind. And I'll come back and I'll end with that great, those great lines. And they kind of summarize this whole discourse on the signs of God. So this poetry, either is from Labid or Imam Shafi'i or some other great, scholar. But what happens is when a great idea is immortalized in verse, what happens is people begin to repeat it so much, becomes one of the wisdoms that are circulated, and it's difficult to see who said them. So he said, "Faya ajaban." كَيْفَ يُعْصَ الْإِلَهُ أَمْ كَيْفَ يَجْحَدُ الْجَاحِدُ. He said, it's amazing how anyone could disobey the Lord, disobey God, and anyone could transgress against Him. وَلِلَّهِ فِي كُلِّ تَحْرِيكَةٍ وَتَسْكِينَةٍ أَبَدًا شَاهِدُ. Every single thing that moves or doesn't move, every motion and state of rest is a witness. And وَفِي كُلِّ شَيْءٍ لَهُ آيَةٌ. Every single thing that exists is a sign تَدُلُّ عَلَىٰ أَنَّهُ وَاحِدُ, that points to the fact that He is one. May Allah open our eyes. May Allah bless us with a productive Ramadan in which our prayers are answered. I will see you all in a subsequent portion. And I wish everyone in MCMC community a blessed Ramadan. And let us pray for each other in this difficult time. Wa sallallahu wa sallama ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.